To my YouTube channel, The Space Between. My name is Saoirse, and today we're going to explore a Ajna themed vinyasa flow. I just wanted to say, first of all, that I'm really sorry I haven't posted in a little while. I still have no Wi-Fi in my house right now, so it's been a little bit challenging trying to get on the internet, and just carving out time to go to the office and a few other spots where I can get Wi-Fi. Last week I just had one of those weeks where I just was running on empty, and I just thought I'd kind of remind you guys that it's so important to have a little bit of R&R, and I'm really harsh on myself for doing that. Like, I am quite a gung-ho kind of person, and last week I had nothing to give. And I kind of felt really guilty about that till like Wednesday, and then I was like, oh, do you know what, if I need to take like a nap every day and watch Bones, then far too many episodes of Bones, then that's just what I'm gonna do. So I did that, and I caught up with like one or two people as well, because I've just been busy with work and I haven't really been socializing. So I'm feeling much better now. I feel like I've got my mojo back. I've got a new project in the works that's related to chakras, which I'm really excited about, a little workshop coming up. I just feel like stimulated again, and kind of like I'm topped up, like I have a little bit more to give. So just kind of a reminder that, you know, it's okay to take some time out for yourself every now and again. I didn't even really practice much yoga last week. I did some sequencing for classes that I'm going to be teaching over the next month or two. And I did a little bit of meditation, but I didn't really have any energy. I just also felt very, really, really drained. Kind of like I've just been hit by a brick wall or something. I don't know why that was, but it just feels good to have stopped and to have had some good quality family time at the weekend. And now I feel like I have some more to give. So I know that, like, in comparison to other YouTube channels, I've only got like a handful of subscribers, but I still think, like, even if you just have one or two people watching, you don't want to let those people down. So I hope I didn't let any of you down. But I do have, quite a few videos in me for this week. So I'm looking forward to sharing some more of this practice with you. And of course, it's now September, so we're actually going to be moving into Muladhara Chakra in a few videos' time. So yeah, I'm excited. I've got some more ideas for that. So yeah, anyway, enough ramble. Let's get on with today's practice. So let's begin in child's pose. You can do a wide-legged one. I find quite restorative. So we're going to bring our knees out to the outer corner edges of our mat. We're going to have our big toes kissing. We're going to allow the sit bones to fall back. And then we're going to bring our forehead to the floor. If you want to, you can rock the head from side to side to stimulate Ajna Chakra here. And try not to let the arms be too passive. Nice stretched out fingers, nice and engaged. Allowing some space between the shoulders and the ears. Bringing it back to the breath. Every time we're inhaling, we're straightening that spine, and every time we exhale, we're allowing our hips to sink a little bit deeper. And if you want to set an intention for today's class, now is a great time to do that. Perhaps your intention is chakra related. Maybe you need some clarity on a situation, or maybe you just want to have a little bit of kind of just some perspective, a fresh perspective on a specific topic or an area of your life, or in general. Maybe you want to focus on a peak posture during today's practice. Maybe it's none of the above. I'm just giving yourself an intention, because when the mind wanders, and it is when, not if, because it always does, when the mind wanders, it's great to have the breath, obviously, to come back to, but it's also nice sometimes to have a little intention there. And colour is indigo.
affirmation. You can have I see or to perceive. I perceive. Exploring Ajna Chakra, the third eye chakra. Element is light.
On your next exhale, coming to a neutral spine, tabletop position. As we inhale, we're going to tilt the pelvis and lift the chin up to the ceiling. You can close your eyes if you'd like. On an exhale, you're going to curl the spine like an angry cat. Inhaling up and exhaling down. Excuse me. And as you inhale, really roll the shoulders away from the ears. And as you exhale, really push the hands down into the mat. Almost like you're trying to separate the shoulders. One more time at your own pace. Good. Come to a neutral spine. Okay, so next what we're going to do is we're going to just have some little hip circles here. So you can bring your hands a little bit further back. Maybe curl the toes if it's more comfortable, or you can have them flat, whatever feels good. We're going to be coming into child's pose. And then as we come up, we're going to drop the hips to the right, over to the left, back into child's pose. You can have a wide leg child's pose, or you can have them slightly more together like I am. And then as we're dropping the hips to the right, we're inhaling, and we reach to the center, we're going to exhale and go back. One more time. Good. This time we're going to drop our hips to the left. Inhale. Exhale. Trying to get those hips a little bit wider each time, making bigger circles. My knee's clicking. Like an old lady. And try and get it a little bit more fluid, like the ocean. Really working on Svadhisthana chakra here, just to warm up. Element of water. Good. Okay, this time we're going to curl the toes under, and we're going to come into our first downward dog. So we're going to lift the tailbone, lift the hips and the knees, and then suck the belly button towards the back of the spine. Hands are nice and spread. We're pushing a little bit more weight into the forefinger and the thumb knuckles here. Can really bend those knees as well and just feel the shoulders rolling back like jam jars, really opening out, creating some space. And then just walk the dog, pedal out the feet a little bit here. Coming into static dog, closing the eyes, taking a breath here. I'm just going to tuck my top in so I don't flash you guys. Taking a nice few deep breaths here, maybe shaking the head. I'm just working out any kinks, making some adjustments. And just really coming into your own expression, whatever feels good for you. And now we're going to come into our, let's do it, come into our first vinyasa. So we're going to come over, we're going to roll over into plank. And I'll have to play around with this a little bit here. So we're kind of really pushing down into the hands. And then I'm just going to try and lower my hips a little bit because I always have my hips way up here. Okay, and then I'm going to bend my knees. And I'm going to bring my chest and chin towards the mat. We're going to allow the feet to straighten, allow the legs to straighten. I'm going to come up onto my elbows here, ready for Sphinx pose. And so I'm going to roll my shoulders back and down. Apparently I'm going to have a yawn as well. and I'm going to have my chin. You can tilt your head up if that feels good for your neck, or you can just have it forward. And then here I'm really going to ground my feet down into the mat. And what I want you to do here is really ground your feet down. And then you're going to come onto your hands, keeping the elbows close to the body for a cobra. You can do a little one if you like. Bhujangasana or cobra. And then here, I want you to relax the feet and pay attention to the lower back. And then I want you to ground the feet down and pay attention once more. Really noticing that feeling, because that's where we want to be. We want to have the lower back supported, and that's why we're grounding down in our feet. Curl the toes under, coming up into downward facing dog. So really grounding the toes down when we're in Bhujangasana, when we're in Cobra. And this helps us to protect our lower spine from injury. And the same goes if you just want to do Sphinx today, that's fine. It's a slightly easier variation on the elbows. And again, we're still grounding down with the feet, protecting our lower spine. Working on getting open in those in the chest and the shoulders. Good, let's roll over into high plank. Second variation, if you want to try it, is doing a lowering down into a plank. And then coming up into Cobra. Curling the toes under. Good. Downward facing dog. And a third variation, if you want to try it, is, let's see if I can do this without falling down. Coming up into plank, lifting one of the legs, lowering the body, and coming up, Cobra, and downward facing dog. Okay, so those are your three options. You can change the leg. If you have one leg lifted, you can change the leg each time so it remains even on both sides. Okay, we're gonna bring that right leg back into three-legged dog. We're gonna bend the knee and rotate the hip open so my gaze comes underneath my right arm. We're going to swing that leg forward, plant it, plant the back knee. And then I'm going to open my front foot a little bit. So I'm just going to bring my right toes to point the outer corner of my mat. I'm going to bring my hands to the inside. You can stay here or you can slowly lower onto your elbows if that feels good. Again, there's no strain in my knee here. So if your knees are uncomfortable, just play around with the distance a little bit. Doing what feels good today. Good. I'm going to open up the knee. So I'm on the outer corner edge of that front foot. I'll just wiggle back so I can show you. So I'm on the outer corner edge of my foot. I'm going to plant my left hand and bring my right hand up. Making sure I'm not sinking the body or the shoulder. Good. Swing that hand down, wiggle the foot so it's facing forward, and step forward either into a forward fold, or if you're up here, you need to use a block, trying to keep that spine straight. So wherever you are today is absolutely fine. Inhale, halfway come up, halfway lift. Exhale a little bit deeper. Planting the hands, stepping or hopping back into our high plank. And then you can lower the body into your choice of Chaturanga. I'm going to be doing the easiest option today, which is just bending my knees. So I already had a heavy yoga practice today. Good. Bring that left leg back, square the hips, bend the knee, rotate that hip open. Gaze comes underneath the left arm. Hello. Good. We're going to swing that left leg forward. Planting the right knee, wiggle those toes so they're facing the outer front corner. Bring the hands to the inside of the foot. You can stay here or you can lower. Again, just playing around a little bit with the distance of this posture. Doing what feels good. Feeling the stretch in the hips. Closing the eyes. Coming back to your intention for today's practice. Coming back to the breath. If you're on your elbows on the next exhale, come up onto the hands and then allow that foot in the front to come onto the outer edge and bring that left hand up. Yes, that's my left hand into the sky. Good. Windmill that hand down, wriggle that front foot and step forward, forward bend. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward bend. Really nice, guys. Let's plant those hands. Step or hop back into high plank. Take your variation of vinyasa. Okay, we're going to lift that right leg and we're going to swing it through. So we're stepping forward, coming into our first high lunge. Ooh. Right, try and really ground the feet. Oh my gosh, my mat just slipped. Try and really ground your feet down. I'm just going to adjust my mat, guys. You can really ground your feet down in this position and also making sure that you've got some space between the shoulders and the ears. Sorry guys, I'm on a really slippy mat and I did not think this through before I started filming this flow. Again, trying to be careful as I slip and slide. Bending that front knee. In fact, you know what? I'm actually just going to get rid of this mat underneath. Sorry guys. Okay, so bending that front knee, you should still be able to see your toes so that you know that your front foot is safe. Sorry, that your front knee is safe. That's better. Sorry about that, guys. Right, let's try that again. There we are. Okay. And almost like you're pushing your feet apart so you're kind of really solid in your foundation. Exhale, open up into Warrior Two. So my back foot is now on a little parallel. My chin is over my middle kind of finger. Again, that knee's bent. Gonna inhale, reach forward. Exhale, come up and over for reverse warrior. Making sure that I'm nice and strong in my side body and that I'm not bending from my lower back. I'm really trying to rotate that shoulder open. Good, and then this time I'm gonna windmill, bring my front right leg, yeah, to it so it's straight. And I'm gonna carry on going down and come into Trikonasana or triangle posture. Really nice and strong, again, in my side body. I'm trying not to slop into it. And try not to put any weight on this leg. Windmill the hands down, bending that knee. Stepping back into your high plank and then taking your variation of a vinyasa. Okay. All right, let's try and do that with less interruptions this time. So bring in the left leg, swinging it forward, stepping up into my high lunge. Feet nice and strong. Exhale, opening up that back foot into Warrior Two. Inhale, flip the wrist, lean forward, really trying to hit to whatever wall that you're aiming for, reaching out. And then we're going to go up and over. Again, try not to slop down, really using the core muscles. Okay, I'm going to straighten that front leg. Windmill the hands down and come into triangle or Trikonasana pose. Lifting almost like someone's holding your right hand. Windmill the hands down, stepping back, taking your variation of a vinyasa. Good. Bringing that right leg forward, coming into our high lunge. Opening out the back foot into Warrior Two. Inhale, lean forward, reach. Exhale, up and over. This time, keeping the front knee bent, I'm going to bring my right elbow to my right knee. Stretching up, or you can reach towards, so that the hand is over the head. If you want to, you can bring the other arm out so it's parallel. Or you can stay here, it's fine. Spread those fingers so they're nice and activated. If it's available to you, keep that knee bent, planting the right hand, looking up at the sky. Bring that hand down, roll onto the ball of the back foot, and then open up the right hand, getting a little bit of a twist on. Do, 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 do. Let's twist again. Oh yeah, always get that song in my head when I do a twist. Planting that front hand, stepping back into a high plank. Knees to your chin or your variation of a vinyasa. Down the dog. Let's repeat that on the left side. So I'm gonna swing my left leg forward into a nice high lunge. Exhale, Warrior Two. Inhale, flip the wrist, lean forward, and then exhale, up and over. Reverse warrior. Keep that front knee bent, bring the left elbow to the left knee. Stretch. Bring the hand over the head if you like. Reach him forward. Engaging those fingers. Bring the other arm up so it's parallel or leave it down. Planting the left hand. Playing around with the distance if you need to. Swing that hand down, come onto the ball of the back foot and then open up. Really like this twist. Plant that hand. Stepping back into high plank. Knees, chest, chin. Your variation of vinyasa. Okay. When you're ready, come down onto your knees. And you can rest in child's pose for a moment. Or you can take a little sip of water. I'm just going to rearrange my towel. Trying to get a good grip. Slide it around. It's okay. Building up a little bit of heat. And when you're ready, let's bring it back to a wide leg child's pose. If you've forgotten, it's okay. Bringing the knees to the outer corner edge of the mat, kissing the big toes.
And bringing the forehead to the mat.
You can come back to your intentions. Or you can just come back to the breath. When you're ready, curl the toes under, lifting the hips, downward facing dog. Bringing that right leg back and stepping it forward into our high lunge. Opening out that back foot into warrior two. And this time, we're going to wiggle out, so we've got a nice wide stance. Going to bring the hands to the hips, roll the shoulders back, chest comes forward, straighten that spine, we're going to slowly lower. If you need to stay here with a block, that's fine. Or a chair or something. If you can, come a little bit lower. If it's available to you, try and bring your forefinger and curl it around your big toe. Trying to keep the spine straight. You can let the head relax. Release the hands, bring them to the center. Turn the fingertips so they're facing towards your bum and then walk the hands back again, trying to keep that spine nice and straight, chest forward. Walking the hands back to center to wriggle the feet to the side a little bit. Sorry, wriggle the feet in a little bit. And then we're going to walk the hands around so that we're in a bit of a lunge. So the right foot's in front again. We're going to step that back, and you know the drill, vinyasa. If you get tired at any point, guys, you can always rest in child's pose, or you can come into a downward facing dog if you want to skip a vinyasa. Bringing that left leg back this time and swinging it forward. I'm actually going to do my right so that I'm facing you guys again, okay? So I'm going to mirror you. So you bring your left leg forward. Flipping that left hand, leaning forward. Stretching out a little bit in the warrior two. And then straightening that leg, bringing the hands to the hips. Nice and wide stance once more. Okay. This time what we're going to do is we're going to interlace the fingers behind your back. And then whatever way you've interlaced them, uninterlace them and interlace them again so that the sort of the odd hand is on top. Roll those shoulders back. Chest is nice and straight. Spine as well. And we're going to come forward into a fold. This time we're going to let the hands do whatever they will. Maybe just let gravity do its thing. I'm trying to keep a nice straight spine. I'm going to lower my left hand to my right foot and have a bit of a twist. I'm going to walk the hands over, bring my right hand to my left foot. And twist. And as I say, I'm mirroring you guys, but you're going to walk your hands around so that your left foot is in front into a lunge. And then you're going to take a step back and do your vinyasa. Good. Okay. Then you're going to step or hop to near the front of your mat. And you're going to make sure that your feet are hip width apart. And again, if you want to, you can use a block or you can hook your forefinger around your big toe. Allow the elbows to drop a little bit to the side if you like. Try to make sure that the knees aren't locked in this position, so you can have a little micro bend in them if that feels good. Releasing the hands. I'm actually going to face you guys for this. So you're going to release your hands, brush your fingertips along your mat, and come up into Utkatasana or chair pose. And you inhale, really tuck the tailbone under. And as you exhale, try and come a bit lower. Bring in the hands to heart center. We're going to bring our left elbow over our right knee, like so. Push the palms together, but also try and keep the knees level so that one of them isn't rocking forward. Try and keep them in line. Good, you're gonna release the hands and you're gonna come to a forward fold once more. This time, if it's available to you, you're gonna put your whole palm underneath your feet, which are hip width apart. Releasing the hands once more, brush the fingertips along the mat and then come up into Utkatasana once more. Try and keep some space between the shoulders and the ears. Bring the hands to heart center. This time we're going to bring the right elbow over the left knee. Again, keeping both knees in line. Really push the hands together to try and open up the chest. Inhale, straighten that spine. Exhale, try and twist a little bit deeper. Good, we're going to release. And this time we're going to open up the feet a little bit and we're going to come down into a yogi squat. So in this position, I feel so tight today, even though I've already done a practice. That's okay. I think sometimes you just have to listen to your body. So maybe you want to rock from side to side. And then I'm inhaling, I'm straightening my spine. And as I'm exhaling, I'm pushing the flesh underneath my knees with my elbows. Try not to push the knees themselves so we don't get injured. Closing the eyes. Bringing it back to the breath. Bringing it back to heart center. Sorry, bringing it back to Ajna Chakra even. You can even bring your hands up if you like, but I quite like having them at this level to open up my knees. You need to put some blocks or cushions underneath your bum to support you. You can, if you're on your toes, that's absolutely fine. I'm going to inhale, come up to standing. Exhale, come down. A little bit like pliés, inhale. Channel your inner dancer today, guys. Exhale. Inhale to standing. Good. You might want to have a little sip of water here, or we're going to continue now into our balancing postures. So we're going to have a little look today at tree posture, which we've explored in some of the other videos I've been doing. I'm going to see how I go today with my balance. Actually, my balance this morning in yoga was pretty terrible, but I always find it difficult in a class. So remember, we're going to have our drishti point, our focus point. Stand a little bit further back. Let's ground down. So I'm going to spread the weight evenly along the feet and really spread those toes and then plant them down. And we're going to bring the weight into our right leg. And you can keep the left heel at the right ankle. You can bring it up under the knee, or you can bring it up that little bit higher. Let's see, I might try and do high today. And again, squaring the hips. So bring the hands to the hips to square them. And it doesn't matter, try not to force the knee up, just let it be where it needs to be. Bring the hands to heart center. Bring the hands to Ajna Chakra. Bring the hands up to the sky. And bring them behind your back. And maybe do a prayer position here. Find that stillness. And release. Shake it out. If you want to, you can of course hold this a little bit longer if you want less of a flow. You can always pause the video if you need to. Okay, grounding down into the left leg this time, spreading those toes. And then this time I'm going to play around. See if I can bring my right leg up here again. These leggings are really slippy. Trying always to mirror your feet, sorry, to mirror your leg. So if you're doing this level on one side, try and do that again on the other. Okay, let's see if I can do this. It's normal to find one side easier than the other. Hands to hips, square the hips. Hands to heart center. Hands to Ajna. Cover the eyes for a second. See how that plays around with your sense of balance. Bring them behind the back. And roll those shoulders open. Try not to drop the hip. Okay, release. Shake it out. Alright, lovely. Well done, guys. Alright, if you want to challenge yourself a little bit further, you can try, I think it's Garudasana or Eagle Posture. There's different variations of this one. I'm going to stick to the one that we've looked at in, I think it was the Sun Salutations we did. Because I just really like this version. So I'm going to ground down into my right foot. I'm going to bring my left foot over. You can twist it and bring it higher if you like. I actually just quite like my toe to be here. Sometimes it hurts my knees. Again, I'm squaring my hips. And then my right leg is kind of holding my weight, is rooted. So I'm going to bring my right hand up, bend at the elbow. And then wrap the left hand around it. Roll the shoulder blades back, suck the belly button in, tailbone is down. Then just lower the hands a little bit. Again, playing with the perspective. So I've got my thumb. I've got my thumb here. And I'm just playing around, flitting between my thumb and the back wall. And then as I'm doing that, I can also I can also try and lower down into this by bending my knees. Maybe playing with taking my toe off, hovering it, really balancing. So great to kind of practice changing the perspective often, because I find it really difficult in life to do that sometimes. Release, shake it out. It's just a little practical exercise to remember that we can look at the little finer details, but we can also bear in mind the bigger picture of things. All right, let's do that on the other side. So spread those left toes, bring in the right leg over this time. Square those hips. Left arm is gonna be bent. Wrapping that right arm around it. Roll the shoulder blades back and down, lowering the hand a little bit, kind of focusing on that thumb and then the back wall. Playing around with lifting my leg. Maybe I want to deepen the pose by bending my knees. Remembering to breathe, guys. Good. Shake it out. Okay, maybe you find one side easier than the other, and that's completely normal. That's fine. Okay. Okay, so let's just come to the front of our mats. Let's push back the hands, play around with the wrists, open that chest, and then lean forward into a forward bend. Let's step back into our downward dog, and then as we inhale, let's roll over into high plank. Exhale, downward dog. Inhale, plank. Exhale, downward dog. Let's do two more of these. Good. I'm gonna bring my let's see if I can do this. Let's do some little jumps, bouncing the knees, and then we're gonna hop into our yogi squat once more. And then I'm feeling a little bit warm now, so I'm gonna just imagine I'm diving into a nice refreshing pool here, guys. I'm gonna lean forward and then slowly, slower than you would like, allow the bum to come into contact with the mat. And we're gonna play around a little bit here with boat posture. So on the tiptoes, finding that balance on the sit bones, rolling the shoulder blades back and down. Maybe I wanna lift the legs. Maybe I wanna lift the arms. Maybe I wanna do full boat. Maybe I wanna do, what's one I always do, I think this one. Ooh, tight hammies today. So I'm actually just gonna do this one. I'm going to hold onto my thighs, pull up a little bit. Every time we do this, we're really trying to lengthen the spine, keeping that balance and also bringing the chest forward. Tap the right toe, tap the left toe, tap both toes. Try and bring it back a little bit further. Tap the right, left, and both. Right, left, and both. Straighten, right, left, and both. Rocking out. Ooh. Just move a little bit, and if you want to, you can rock it out here into halasana, which is when we have our feet over our head. If you're not too sure about this one, it's absolutely fine. Just practice playing around with it a little bit. I'll probably try and break this posture down for you in a hatha video because it'll be much slower. So if it's in your practice, feel free to do it. If you're new and you're a bit nervous about it, just leave it for next time. Listen to the body. Okay, I'm gonna come to a nice, deceptively relaxing position on the floor. I'm gonna bend my knees so that my hands can tickle my heels. And I'm gonna raise my hips. And then exhale, release. Inhale. Exhale. One more time, inhale, hold it a bit longer this time. Maybe come onto the toes. And release, really slowly. Oh, let the tailbone just sink into the mat. This time we're gonna bring our hands so that they're gonna clasp behind our backs, and we're gonna shuffle onto our shoulders. So we're gonna raise our hips, clasp the hands and shuffle, 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 if it's available to you. Maybe again, you want to practice coming onto the toes. Again, try not to let the knees splay out for this posture. Maybe bring the right leg up and put it down. Maybe bring the left leg up and put it down. Release the hands, shuffle out the shoulders, and then slowly release back into the floor. Lovely. Okay. I'm going to hug our knees. Give yourselves a nice big squeeze, a big hug for practicing today. And then we're gonna lift the head. We're gonna squeeze, squeeze, squeeze at the core. Squeezing the head, squeezing everything. Nice and tight. And release. Now bring our knees to our armpits and hold onto the inside of our feet. Rocking from side to side in happy baby pose. Giving yourself a nice well-needed massage. Closing the eyes, being aware now of any areas of tension, and just breathing into them. Focusing on the forehead. Ajna chakra color is purple or indigo. Element is light. And we're going to just come down into Shavasana now, guys. So any adjustments that you need, if you want to take a little sip of water, now is a great time. She says, you can get a pillow, you can get a blanket. If you've got some lavender spray, go crazy, man. Whatever feels good. I don't know why I'm doing this, actually, because I'm actually really, really hot now. And there's no windows open in my room, so. No fresh air, but it's cool. Love spraying a bit of lavender spray onto my blanket. If you want to know why I'm using lavender, just check out my tea talk on here on YouTube and it'll explain everything. All right, so we're just going to allow the feet to drop to the outer corner edges of the mat. Lift up those the shoulders, have a little shuffle, bring the hands out, closing the eyes. Oh, and taking some nice deep breaths. You have a few options here now, so you can lie here and just enjoy some peace and quiet for a minimum of 5 minutes. Try and give yourself longer if you have it. You could play a track of music for Ajna Chakra. You could even put on a guided meditation if you wanted to. Or you can just do a gentle body scan from the crown of the head all the way down the face, down the left arm, the right arm, down the body to the hips, and down the left leg and right leg. Nice and slowly, just being aware of the body. I'm going to leave this video here so that you guys can wrap up in your own time. Like I say, try and give yourself at least 5 minutes. Played around with energy today, so it's nice to just let it all settle. And then whenever you're ready, after those 5 minutes, you can just leave your mat in whatever way you like, really. Just going to bring the hands to heart center. I'm just going to say thank you guys very much for practicing with me today. Can't wait to share some new videos with you all. And like I say, give yourselves 5 minutes or so. Longer if you have it. Try not to fall asleep. If you do, I guess that's fine. Namaste. Live light and be light. Thank you, guys.